All right, fast travel again, buddies. All
right, sounds good. What up, everybody? It's me and Soldier Pat out here, and we're playing some Division 2. Finally, it's here. Not live right now, but recording some footage for future YouTube video. So we'll see how that goes.
Yeah.
I'm not really much of a vendor person.
I just sell it.
For myself.
Sell it junk.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm gonna buy anything.
Do you want to fast travel there or just run? I'm fine with
that. No. Fast travel.
Okay.
1 kilometer's too far.
Yeah, right.
Actually, it's not even 1 kilometer.
It's 200. It's about 200 meters.
Yeah, too far.
That's me in every game though that has fast travel. I'll literally, if I can fast travel somewhere, I always do. Literally, it saves so much time, and it's just nice. Oh, there's some vanity boots over here.
I feel bad for fast traveling in games like Assassin's Creed and Witcher because their worlds are so awesome.
I know. Those are games that, I mean, even, it depends. If I'm on a time crunch, I'll do it. But, like, if I kind of want to experience it, right, then sometimes I won't. But okay, 95% of the time, I do. Just because it saves time. So, you like the gunplay so far?
Oh, yeah. Very much so. I don't know why, because I did not like the first Division. But after the beta, I bought the first Division for like $7 to play it a little bit. And I love it.
Yeah, I kind of wish I did get into it again. I played it all on Xbox. And I wanted to get into it again on PC, but I never went all the way through with it. So I never really got to finish my playthrough on PC, but definitely, I think it felt better playing on PC than when originally played it. Especially with all the updates and everything they made. I'm really looking forward to seeing where this one goes.
I'm heading upstairs to the hostage.
I just want to fight the Black Tusk, or whatever they're called.
That's such a cool aspect to it. Just in the beginning.
And the world tiers and shit like that. We need to kill this asshole. Apparently there's 5, but the 5th one isn't out right away. Maybe 4 right away, and apparently they're all gonna take a little while. The deck of 52, just like a very mercenaries feel, which I like.
Turn my in-game volume down just a bit.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to do that too. Oh, you can shoot grenades out of the air.
Oh yeah, I haven't used my my new ability yet. All right, I'm gonna test in game chat real quick. Test. Soldier Pack, can you hear me in chat?
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool.
Yep.
Cool. You're almost done. Played this mission, I think it is like my 6th or 7th time now, combined with the beta, both the private and the public. And I don't think I had access to the closed. I don't remember.
Went all the way to the top floor. Take the stairs to the right.
I think that's
actually
the private. I like how you can see the equipment hanging off your backpack. It's pretty cool. Like, so you can see my little the hive.
Oh, yeah.
And see the capital.
Yeah.
Trinket that I have.
Yeah.
Do you have that one too?
No, I didn't equip it.
Oh. Okay.
I just have the one. I didn't know I could equip both. I was just one or the other.
Well, yeah. You can equip one of the other, but did you unlock it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I saw it in there.
that one you get for, there's two of them. There's one that you get for just playing the beta, and then there's one, the other one is, I think, is it, I guess it's the one that you have on?
Yeah.
For the Dark Zone?
Yeah, yeah. For okay. completing, like, the eastern portion or whatever.
Yes, sir. Did you check out any of the free stuff you get for Uplay points and all that?
No, not yet.
Okay. I unlocked, you get a ghost patch that you can put on your, the thing on your arm.
Oh, it's the vision patch?
Yeah.
Ooh.
You can get a ghost one or a Rainbow Six, to put on your shoulder instead of the division patch. So like if you look at my right arm, you can actually see the ghost logo instead. Then they have a few camos and other little things. The starting materials, which I got just in case if they're actually useful. Yeah, use this. I want to see how long this actually lasts. And does it heal?
I think it healed my armor.
Okay, it did?
Yeah.
I think it healed mine a bit too.
Unless it just did that on its own. But it go back to it. Oh, no, that was the last enemy.
Yeah.
Sad face.
Let it refresh.
Let me turn down my game audio.
I just found an ammo stockpile. I'm gonna detonate it.
Ammo.
Alright, should be good. What's the, what's that button?
H. Cats has to tell Thanos to wait. Thanos is on the phone. Oh. I was confused. Yours said it
yeah,
too.
It
what's the other one? We get Scout too. He's holding. He's holding the binoculars upside down for me, or almost. They're like inverted. A little bit. I don't think I've ever seen. I mean, not off the top of my head. I don't know if there's ever been a game that had the fires the bullet on pull and release of the trigger.
Yeah, it's gun. Very hard to get used to.
Especially when the recoil is actually
so high.
Yeah.
I can't do anything long range.
That's what you get, you dumb sons of bitches.
You doing all right there, Kelso?
As long as
second
not
you,
asbestos,
you pull the trigger, you have to start
damage.
Aiming downwards a little bit.
This is a clean ass elevator, jeez.
Right. So we got the Secret Service agent and the fireman.
The veteran firefighter. I was just about to retire when I got the call.
I like how they, without any spoilers, I like how they set up the beginning of the game.
Yeah, like at New York.
Yeah, that's pretty
cool. You can cut that out if that was spoiler.
Nah, I mean, that's where you're at in the first game. But I just don't want to talk. I mean, I'm sure anyone that's watching by now probably has played that part, but it's still pretty cool the way that it was set up.
Yeah, just linked it to almost immediately.
Yeah. I really like how they made this game, like, you don't need to play the first one. You can pretty much just hop in on this one.
Yeah, it's pretty
and
much
understand
what I did.
Everything. Yeah, that's true.
I didn't even get halfway through.
The roof, there really was. I mean, there's a lot of what I was saying earlier is there's a lot of internal like lore. I feel like the lore is mainly based on the first game rather than going to the first and the second in a way. Like maybe the hyenas, like you get a lot of lore about the enemies and like where they come from. So I mean maybe that there are some like interesting things with like rogue agents in the story too, but like there's not like super, you have this guy and he's like the super 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 bad guy and he's gonna be in every single game.
Oops. Yeah, where's my Thanos version of this game?
Glad you made it. Did you see Captain Marvel yet?
No, not yet. I heard it wasn't that good, and I decided against it.
Yeah, $550 million on the
first weekend
says otherwise.
I mean, Venom did good, I mean, and it wasn't that great.
Yeah, that's true. But no, I really liked it. I definitely recommend it.
Kind of wanted to see it just for the for Samuel Jackson.
Yep, it's
and tie-in.
I feel like the entire reason, I mean personally, before Endgame and everything, or I mean before Infinity War, I like the only movies I would actually go and see were like the big ones like Spider-Man or Iron Man. I never went to theaters to see Captain America or Thor until things started getting ramped up. Same. When they started to. But I think that's changed my opinion now. Like, I'll go see them, maybe not on, like, the first night like I did with Captain Marvel or, like, Civil War. Like, those movies, because they have such a big impact on the story and everything else, I'll see on, like, the first night they come out or, like, that Friday. But, like, the other ones, if it's just, like, a regular storyline, I'll see them in the theaters at least. But this one, oh my god. All I'm gonna say is Thanos is in for some he's in for it. He's in trouble.
Yeah, I heard Captain Marvel is gonna have a real big impact on the next movie.
Oh yeah. Oh yes. I'm so excited. I have my notifications just waiting to see what happens next and when the tickets go on sale. I may possibly go see it Thursday night when movies do actually release.
Oh, releases on a Thursday?
Yeah, the movies always come out on Thursday night, and they usually, the first time they play is usually around 10 o'clock, because by the time you're done watching the movie, it's midnight. Majority of the time.
Maybe. Yeah, I could do that.
But, hey, if you want to go, but
I'll leave it. I work on a Thursday night.
I have class on Thursday nights. But that's the thing, is they start, I have class until 10.
Yeah, I work until 10.
Exactly.
If I go, I'm going to be smelly.
I don't know. I'm thinking about it. I don't know if I want to... I mean, if I do, I don't know if I want to stay up until... Because Avengers Endgame is supposed to be 3 hours long. Or just about,
really?
If not. Yeah.
Oh, I'm excited.
It's literally going to be like 3 hours long. From what I've seen so far, so I don't know if I want to go actually see it in the theaters at 10 o'clock. But then if you go at that time or later, like actually if you go around like the 10 or 11 time frame, I'm sure there's nobody there. Or like if there is, it's all like adults. Because when I saw Captain Marvel, it was some little kid, which he didn't know any better, but he was talking like to his friend a lot. Pretty annoying. But.
If they have friends in the theater, they know better.
I know.
They're old enough to know better. They're old enough to know the social cues.
Well, not like... I mean, he was with his dad, which his dad didn't seem like he said anything. But...
Get your kid in order.
I know.
I'm trying to enjoy my movie.
I mean, luckily, like, the kid... It was, like, I was sharing the same excitement of the kid, but at the same time, I was just like, bro, like...
I want to be in the moment, and you're not letting me be in the moment.
Yeah, especially, like, when there's things that just happen in the movie, and he's like, oh my god, that's this person from this movie. Like, yeah.
Oh, no, one of those.
Everybody knows that.
Is Odessa on the line?
I'll patch her in. Odessa?
Yeah, there's some... Or, like, the first time, obviously, and this isn't a spoiler, the first time that they pull out the pager from...
Oh, it's like, oh, it's from that movie.
Yeah.
It's the same one.
Oh, that's the pager from the end scene. That's the pager. Like, yes, we all know that. That's why they did that.
We were all there. Literally everyone in the whole world saw that movie. It's been on DVD for a while.
Pretty much. But overall, yeah, it was a lot of fun. I really liked it. I cannot wait. And then I'm wondering where it's going to go from there. And then we have Spider-Man. What, is Spider-Man coming out this year?
Yeah, it's coming out in June.
June? Okay.
Yeah. Excited for that.
Jeez. Yeah.
Let's see how they work with Mysterio.
Jake Gyllenhaal, don't you?
Oh, I do, yeah.
Yeah.
Ever since Nightcrawler, he's been one of my favorite actors.
Yeah. He's definitely up there for me, too. For favorite actors. Get any new weapons.
Right. Now, let me fast travel.
Yeah, I can't. I'm always indecisive about swapping out weapons because I have some of these that are level 3, but at the same time, I have lower level weapons that do more damage. So it's like,
I always choose the one to do more damage.
Yeah.
And if they do more damage and they're single fire, I'd choose not to do that. I don't like single fire weapons.
Okay.
Unless it's like a freaking exotic weapon like this one.
Marcus junk.
And it does not look like this gun levels up with you.
Yeah. That's unfortunate. I don't know why they would give it at such like a low level.
Yeah, I feel like to the shotgun.
If you gave it to at it like a higher level or something, it would be more effective. I mean, it's still pretty nice, but
all right. I have a lot to do here. What the heck? I'd be drinking beers on the lake. Some projects.
Yeah, I'm like 10 meters, 30 meters away.
If you have business in the theater, please remove your firearm and state your name at the entrance.
When you're 30 meters away, but still debating on fast traveling.
I see it.
I love the music that plays.
Do I have steel? I have no steel. Alright.
I can't give the... Oh, there we go. Donate.
I guess I could donate all my items. For projects.
Meet with Odessa.
Oops, side mission here. Oh. We got like 3 new main missions.
Yeah. You see are you in the map?
Yeah.
Right now? Okay.
Yeah, but they're all level 4, level 7, all 11. You gotta do some side stuff, you know what I'm saying? There's
Mr. Michael Davis. Where's the... It says there's agent notes nearby. detected until behind. Like how you can actually see them on the map. Oh, that's projects. Actually, no, you can't.
Speak with Odessia. I guess she's in here. Ooh, hello, beautiful.
4 kilometers. Disinfectant, use minimum amount, and wash hands. .5 kilometers. I don't know where this. I'm trying to find the notes while I wait.
You have unlocked new main missions. Complete main missions.
I'm up to do practically any mission.
We have to level up a little bit, so we can do this settlement or this demolition site that's near us.
Where? Oh, this guy.
Okay. It's a red flag.
Selected by Thanos. I see that you selected it. I'm gonna make my way there.
Okay.
Did you see the echo, or did you watch that echo on your way over to the theater for the first time?
Oh, I didn't even see an echo.
It's a very heavy story echo.
Ooh.
Not actually not very heavy, but it is a little bit. It has something to do with Manny.
Oh, I have no idea who that is.
The guy that you meet at the White House for the first time, like when you first get there. He's the one that puts out like the distress signal and everything. I don't think he was in the first one. Oh, so you know how I asked you to play Wildlands earlier? Remember how I asked you if you wanted to play Wildlands earlier? I launched it yesterday and I was just doing a little bit of co-op, just with some randoms, and I hopped in a car, and when I hopped in the car, there was a woman on the radio talking about how things are getting really bad, and then she brings up DC, and then she was like, yeah, the division agents, they're everywhere, it's getting really bad out there. And then, like, the radio cuts off. But I thought that was pretty cool. That means that they, at one point, they had to go into that game, update it, just so they could add a little dialogue sequence within Wildlands regarding DC and the agents. They've been updating that game a lot, though.
What's the, that division called, and like, well, what's that? Are they the army, or are they like special forces in that game? I forget what they're called.
What?
In the Wildlands, like the people you play as, the Americans.
The ghosts.
Oh, they're ghosts.
Yeah, they're just regular ghosts. Pretty sure.
They need to add the ghosts into this game.
That would be sick.
Like a little DLC.
Reinforcements incoming.
Oh, we're getting flanked too.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, the shotgun's a lot better.
I love it. They did some event. Dude, I think it's coming.
Oh, an event will be the better.
Well, yeah, that would be sick. An event, or what I was gonna say in an event with Sam Fisher, like they did in Wildlands, but I don't know how they would do that. Yeah, you know, in Far Cry New Dawn, there's a, you know how you can travel outside the map? I haven't played it yet. Well, there are some small areas. They're like little, I think they're mini missions, but you can basically travel outside the map. And when you do so, there's one where you can go to like Montana or something. Or not Montana, it's somewhere else basically. And there's a plane, and it's the plane from the Splinter Cell games, and you can find some notes from Sam Fisher for what he did before the bombs dropped from Far Cry. And you can also find a thing on the table of it shows the world map, and then it like glitches out for a second. But after you do that, you hear something unlock, and you hear the classic noise of the lights turning on.
Oh, the...
Yeah, that. And then you can actually get his outfit. You can find it in the ship and wear it.
That's actually pretty freaking awesome.
Yeah. I will 100% say that I think right as of right now, Ubisoft is my favorite.
Detecting additional hostile contacts.
Game publishers, developers.
I mean, it would be Blizzard for me, but they're not doing so hot.
Nope. Ubisoft, I mean, honestly, if I think about it, they've probably been my favorite for a while because of Assassin's Creed and Watch Dogs, and they have some of my favorite franchises. I mean, Far Cry, yeah, it's pretty cool. I've always liked those games, but like, I love Assassin's Creed. I love Watch Dogs. I love The Division. And they're not like, they're making their money still without being excessive about it. They're not an Activision or
EA.
Oh
god. Yeah, it's really bad over there.
So I have a lot of respect for Ubisoft at the moment.
Supply room access.
Things always change. It probably will someday. I remember years ago they were the company that everyone was like, oh, but Ubisoft sucks. Oh, but they're losing their ways. And now, honestly, they're probably one of the better ones today.
Oh, yeah. There's a loot room here. Yeah, okay. Loot room.
Is there like a chest?
Yeah, there's a couple chests in here.
I see that he received a bunch of stuff. I wonder if these places get taken back over again.
I hope so. That was kind of neat loot room.
Sweet.
All right, let's get that. Get rid of that. Take
probably
that,
run
that.
One more mission and then end this video. Depending on what we're doing here.
Oh yeah. At what level are we? 3 still. We need to be level 4.
I am a side mission. 4, but we can do any, whatever.
No, maybe we can go do that mission then. The main mission.
Well, let's, hold on.
I thought you said anything.
I don't mind doing a side mission in one of these games. Because I mean, it would just over-level us, which is always nice.
Well, 4 is minimum. It goes max up to 8.
Okay. I'm wondering, are these weapons better now? Yes, they are. RIP. Oh, how about the shotgun is then? All right, I'm switching to the shotgun then.
The shotgun exotic one?
Yeah.
Yeah, exotic.
It's so much better than... I mean, honestly, at this point, why would you even use the Ruthless one? Because there's... I mean, it does 300. I guess maybe the point is it's just something that you start with. But I don't know. I'm back and forth about that. Can't change grenades yet. All right, what's side mission?
The one closest to us on the top.
Do you want to grab that safe house first?
There's a safe house nearby?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's get the safe house.
Yeah. I figured because it's pretty much on the way, and then once you unlock that one time, you unlock it for good. One thing I loved about the first game was every time I would run, or not every time, but if I think I created like a new agent one time on Xbox, but if you didn't unlock a safe house and you had a friend, you could fast travel, if they are kind enough to go to fast travel to each safe house, then you could fast travel on them and it would auto unlock the safe house.
Oh, that's nice. Free respawn points, basically. Yeah.
Respawn points, and every time you... I haven't seen the feature in this one yet, but every time you go to the safe house in the first one, there was a board in the room, and then it would unlock all of the local missions and the free roam events, which were pretty... They're all minuscule things, but still gave you more to do every time you found a new safe house.
This is the only place around here that the hyenas didn't dare to touch. That's good news for you. That's really interesting intel here.
Nice. So it looks like when you unlock it, it unlocks it for me.
Looks like you got your hands full. Good luck.
Ah. Shade tech cache. Okay. Detected. So... right here, it,
fuck.
Downtown East Liberation, resupply a friendly control point, complete activities in Downtown East, and recover SHD tech caches in Downtown East. So I think it reveals all of the SHD tech caches. Yeah, it does. Okay. See the, whenever you get the chance to look at the map, there's the division logos. Those are basically the points to unlock new skills and perks.
Oh, the perk points.
Yeah.
Basically.
And they're literally just little cash. I mean, you get them from doing missions too, but it's a quick, like, if you're running by, you might as well grab it. I don't have the slightest
idea how the theater needs new batteries. There's also another control point nearby too. Let's get the side mission first though.
So I'm wondering, how do they work? Is it just
how did it work?
The control points, you just go to them and like, cause now I see the other one that we just did, and it shows a green flag and then it shows three stars. So I wonder if they actually do get taken over. That's something
you might have to go to it and defend it too. True. Maybe don't defend it, gets also taken over.
It's a cool little thing.
Already has way more content than Anthem.
I know. I
haven't even done the PvP yet.
I think.
Huh? So much to do, Cassis, so little time.
I know, literally. So much to do, so little time. But I'm planning on spending a lot of time in this game.
Oh, I am. I spent $100 to play it early.
Yeah.
I never do that.
Mm-hmm.
But I was, my excitement got the better of me.
I used to do it a lot for a lot of games that I totally shouldn't have. But this is one of those games where I love the first one. So now I'm ready for this. This is going to hold me off for quite a while.
Find a way inside and take a look. The theater needs some for their communications equipment.
Or if I mean, I'm sure I'll have those moments where I get a little tired, play something else, but I plan on coming back to this game. At least, like, hopefully once a week or so. At least. It's so nice if I finally got an LMG. I love the LMGs in this game.
How do you open this? Shit? Ooh, here. There's loot.
Oh.
Here.
Whoops. Yeah, I always forget about them.
I got another gun. That was worth.
Got a shotgun. Got a new chest plate. Let's see. Is the shotgun better than my current one? No, it's not. Alright, well that's good. Yeah, I definitely want to swap out my, in this game, it seems like the spotting technique is not really worth it so far.
No, we kind of just run and shoot.
Yeah, I mean, you'll see them one way or another, but unless if there's something I'm missing, I mean, maybe they give you a little bit of a stat boost, because in the first one, you literally got a stat boost for your damage, and or you would get it for those like special, I forget how that worked, like each specialization had like an ultimate version of that specialization once you hit a certain level or like max level. I forget though, I can't remember how it worked. Basically, like, you know how right now, the abilities, like, they have three different versions.
Yeah.
And you choose which one you want. Pretty much when you would hit a certain level or something like that, it would unlock another version that was, like, almost of the three separate ones combined. So it was, like, the best you could get. But I don't know.
What the heck?
What was that?
I don't know.
A rocket?
It felt like it. God, this shotgun's beast.
Yeah, I actually really like this one. All I need now is that Russo voice line.
Vikram Malik, the CTO of Odia.
No, Russo!
Russo!
Get him out of there.
Russo! And they, a Punisher Bonnie armor. Remember when your phone ringing used to disconnect?
You mean yours? It was always yours.
Yeah, I know. Well, I mean, at one point in the internet worlds, that was a thing for everyone.
Oh, really?
Not just me.
I must have. I joined the multiplayer game really late compared to you guys, and I think when I did, they fixed that because I never had that issue, or it was mostly fixed.
I don't know who we had when that happened. That was so bad, though. I used to hate that. Because I would be, like, playing, like, I mean, it even happens still today a little bit. Across my fingers, it hasn't happened to me. We're in Discord right now, and I haven't had that issue in a few days now.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did that ticket help?
No. They pretty much said, so I opened the ticket, saying that in certain times, Discord disconnects me from everything, but then stays connected to Discord. And I checked with my ISP and everything. It's nothing to do with that. So I opened it and they're like, yeah, this is a known issue at the moment. We don't have a fix. Please try, if it does happen, please try it in the web browser. See if it persists in that. They gave me a few things, alternative things to try. But they're like, yeah, this is like, I think it's one of those, like, it happens, but it's not like super, super common. It's like one of those one-off things. No, I mean, there are other people that get it. It's not just me. I know that because I've seen so many threads on Reddit opened up about it. Or like, just Twitter. I've seen tweets about it too. But luckily, I haven't really ran into the issue for a little bit now.
Are you using your browser like they... he said to do or no?
No. My goal is that if, I mean, it would be nice if it never happens, but in reality, it probably will happen eventually. So when it does, I'm going to see if it does it. If it does it more than two or three times, then at that point, I'll open up a browser and see if it continues through there.
Maybe Malik will be able to help us out somewhere down the line.
But
let's call this one agent. Move out.
For now, I'm going to go ahead and end this video. So, thanks for coming by, everyone. If you liked this, make sure you hit that like button. If you got any feedback, please leave some comments. Join us in the Discord. Come and chat about The Division or any other game coming out. And if you like this in general, subscribe as well. Anyways, peace out. And I'll see you guys in the next one.